My name is Milani.
I'm a curriculum development intern here at Code.org, and I'm also a computer science student at Cascadia College.
I always liked the fact that I can make whatever I want with computer science. I've been able to make really cool websites that are about topics I'm really passionate about, and I just really enjoy that there's so many different ways to express myself through such an outlet.
Websites are everywhere, and they're the primary way many people get their news, keep up with friends' activities, learn new information, and share the details of their lives. Right now, you might be a consumer of websites created by others, but you're about to learn how to be a website creator with the power to make and share something brand new with the entire world. To do this, you'll be using WebLab, a unique tool that allows you to create your own websites with many of the same capabilities as a professional web developer. The instructions section includes directions for the project you're currently working on. When you're ready, you can collapse the instructions and shrink the size. Below the instructions, WebLab has a list of files and images that will appear on the website. Just like a news website has different pages for the front page, the arts and entertainment page, and the science page, your website will eventually have multiple pages based on files stored here. To edit a web page, you'll need to navigate to the right file name that corresponds to that page. Every project starts with a single index.html file, which is the main page of your website. When you click on the index.html file, it pulls up the contents of the file over here in the workspace. The workspace is where you develop your website. You can start by typing anything in the workspace. Let's put a title at the top of our page, followed by a paragraph about our page. As you type, you may see some of your changes appear automatically in the preview area. Some kinds of changes will not appear automatically. If your change doesn't appear immediately, just click the refresh button above the preview area to update the preview. You'll notice that all the content on your web page gets lumped together, which is not what we want. But stay tuned. You'll soon learn ways to better control how your content appears.